वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स चैप्टर 3 इन क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 9 एंड द टॉपिक इज मॉलिक्यूलर मास, मोल कॉन्सेप्ट एंड एवोगाड्रोज नंबर. एज यू डू एजुकेशन, प्लीज लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एज यू डू एजुकेशन. डोंट फॉरगेट टू क्लिक द बेल आइकन. Watch the video carefully and repeatedly to understand properly. Stay tuned for all video updates. Please comment in the comment box for all your doubts in this chapter. I will make video for all questions raised by students. Please don't skip the video, otherwise you will miss the important part. All the numericals are solved very carefully and clearly. Still, if any single student is unable to understand any part of the video, please let me know in the comment box. Now, we will start the topic molecular mass and mole concept. So, today's topic is molecular mass and mole concept. The first is molecular mass. So now student, what is the molecular mass? The molecular mass of a substance is the sum of the atomic masses of all the atoms in a molecule of the substance. Look at here students, sum of the atomic masses of the atoms in a molecule of the substance. It is therefore the relative mass of a molecule expressed in atomic mass unit, which is denoted by U, small u. Now, the example, first example, calculate the relative molecular mass of water. And we know that the formula of water is H2O. Now, the solution, atomic masses of hydrogen. Because water, it's two molecules, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen react to each other. It will form water. So, the atomic masses of hydrogen, this is 1U. Hydrogen atomic mass is 1. And oxygen's atomic mass is 16U. Because why here is U? It's a molecular mass. It's not in gram. So, the molecular mass of water, which contains two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen, is 2 into 1 plus. This is the sum of the atomic mass. So, 2 into 1 plus 1 into 16. Why? H2O. So, that's why hydrogen atomic mass is 1 and it's two atoms of hydrogen. So, that's why 2 into 1 plus one atom of oxygen, so that's why 1 into atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So, 2 into 1 plus 1 into 16 is equal to 18U. So, the relative molecular mass of water is 18U. Okay. Now, the second examples, calculate the molecular mass of HNO3, nitric acid, HNO3 nitric acid. So, how many atoms, how many elements are present in this compound? There is a 3 elements. Name of these elements? Hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. Now the solution, the molecular mass of HNO3, the atomic mass of hydrogen plus the atomic mass of nitrogen plus 3 into the atomic mass of oxygen. Why 3 into the atomic mass of oxygen? Because the formula of nitric acid is HNO3. There is a 3 atoms of oxygen. So, that's why 3 into the atomic mass of oxygen. Now, the solution 1 into 14. 1 means hydrogen atomic mass is 1. Nitrogen atomic mass is 14 and oxygen atomic mass is 16, so 3 into 16 is equal to 48. And the sum of the atomic masses of the atoms in a molecule of the substance, this is 63 U. So that means the molecular mass of HNO3 is 63 U. Clear? Now the next is formula unit mass. What is the formula unit mass? The formula unit mass of a substance is a sum of the atomic masses of all atoms in a formula unit of a compound. Formula unit mass is calculated in the same manner as we calculate the molecular mass. Okay? The only difference is that we use the word formula unit for those substances whose constituents particles are ions. For example, hydrogen chloride, HCl, as discussed above, has a formula unit HCl. Its formula unit mass can be calculated as H atomic mass, hydrogen atomic mass is 1, so 1 into 1, plus chlorine. Its atomic mass is 35.5, so that's why 1 into 35.5 is equal to 36.5 U. So hydrochloric acids is formula unit mass is 36.5 U. Now the definition of atomic mass. What is the atomic mass? The atomic mass of an element is the mass of one atom of that element in atomic mass unit or U. Atomic mass unit AMU, 1 by 12th of the mass of an atom of carbon 12 is called atomic mass unit. It is a unit of mass used to express atomic masses and molecular masses. Now the next is molar mass. The molar mass of an element is equal to the numerical value of the atomic mass. However, in case of molar mass, the units change from U to G, G for gram. The molar mass of an atom is also known as gram atomic mass. For example, the atomic mass of carbon is equal to 12 atomic mass unit. Clear? So the gram atomic mass of carbon is 12 grams. So when it's a atomic mass of carbon only, that is only 12 atomic mass unit, means 12 U. When it's gram atomic mass of carbon, that time it's 12 G. Now the next is molecular mass of the molecule. The sum of the atomic masses of all the atoms in a molecule of a substance is called the molecular mass of the molecule. Now, the molecular mass calculation. Generally, we use relative atomic masses of atoms for calculating the molecular mass of one mole of any molecular or ionic substances. Example, molecular mass of sulfuric acid or H2SO4. Now the first of all, atomic masses of hydrogen. Mass of hydrogen, 1. Atomic mass of sulfur, 32. Atomic mass of oxygen, 16. Now what is the molecular mass of H2SO4? This is also 2 into atomic mass of hydrogen plus 1 into atomic mass of sulfur plus 4 into atomic mass of oxygen. So the calculation, 2 into 32 plus 2 into 1 plus 32 plus 4 into 16, so is equal to 98 U. So the molecular mass of H2SO4 is 98 U. Calculation of molecular mass of hydrogen chloride, atomic mass of hydrogen plus atomic mass of chlorine. So this is also 1 into 1 plus 35.5 is equal to 36.5 U. Now again I am repeating formula unit mass. The formula unit mass of a substance is the sum of the atomic masses of all atoms in a formula unit of a compound. The term formula unit is used for those substances which are made up of ions. Formula unit mass of sodium chloride, this is also 1 into atomic mass of sodium plus 1 into atomic mass of chlorine. So now 1 into sodium's atomic mass is 23 plus 1 into chlorine's atomic mass is 35.5. So is equal to 58.5 atomic mass units or AMU. Now the formula unit mass of zinc oxide or ZnO. 1 into atomic mass of zinc plus 1 into atomic mass of oxygen. So atomic mass of zinc is 65. So that's why 1 into 65 plus 1 into atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So the total is 81 U. So that is the formula unit mass of zinc oxide is 81 U. Now the next topic is mole concept. Now the students, first of all, what is the mole concept? One mole of one species means, species means atoms, molecules, ions or particles, is that quantity in number having a mass equal to its atomic or molecular mass in grams. Okay, so this is called the mole concept. Mole is the measurement in chemistry. It is used to express the amount of chemical substance. One mole is defined as the amount of substance of a system which contains as many entities like atoms, molecules and ions are there are atoms in 12 gram of carbon. It's just like one mole of any species, it's that is atoms, molecules, ions or particles, is that quantity is number having a mass equal to its atomic or molecular mass in gram. Okay, so the next is Avogadro number. Now what is the Avogadro number? The number of the particles present in one mole of any substance is equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Any substance means it may be atoms, it's may be molecules, ions or particles. Any substance is equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. This 6.022 into 10 to the power 23, it's called Avogadro's number or Avogadro's constant. This is called Avogadro's number. Avogadro's constant. Number of particles in one mole. One mole of hydrogen atoms represents 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 hydrogen atoms. One mole of hydrogen molecules represents 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 hydrogen molecules. One mole of water molecules represents 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 water molecules. Why? Because the one mole of any species may be its atoms, molecules, ions or particles. So that's why every like hydrogen atoms, hydrogen molecules, water molecules, all are the Avogadro's number are same, 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Now, this is the diagram. One mole of carbon atoms, it's 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of carbon. It's the left side. And the right side, 12 gram of carbon. Now, the one mole of hydrogen atoms, same, The Avogadro's constant or number 6.022 × 10²³ atoms of hydrogen, but in gram, 1 gram of hydrogen atoms. Third, 1 mole of any particles, same the Avogadro's constant, 6.022 × 10²³ numbers of that particles, but the relative mass of those particles in grams. And 1 mole of molecules, 6.022 × 10²³ numbers of molecules and molecular mass in gram. Now the formulas: Avogadro's number, number of particles and moles, conversion formula. Number of moles, which is denoted by small n. Number of moles denoted by small n. Its formula is number of moles is equal to given number of particles, this is denoted by capital N, by Avogadro number. Avogadro number denoted by capital N, O or 0. Okay. So what is the formula? Number of moles is equal to given number of particles by Avogadro number. Example, find the number of moles present in 24.088 × 10²³ particles of carbon dioxide. One mole of carbon dioxide contains 6.022 × 10². Now the solution, the number of moles small n, given number of particles by Avogadro's number, this is the formula. So given number of particles, which is already given, 24.088 × 10², and we know that the 1 mole of carbon dioxide contains 6.022 × 10², that means this is the Avogadro number. So the result will be 4 moles. Now the next formula, number of atoms small n is equal to given mass small m by molar mass capital M into Avogadro number. Now the example, calculate the number of atoms in 48 gram of magnesium. Solution, number of atoms is equal to given mass by molar mass into Avogadro's number. This is the formula. So given mass, which already given, 48 gram of magnesium. So 48 by molar mass. Magnesium, its atomic mass is 24. So 48 by 24 into Avogadro's number 6.022 × 10²³. So its result will be 12.04 × 10²³ atoms. Now the next formula, number of moles is equal to given mass by molar mass into Avogadro's number. Example, calculate the number of molecules in 3.6 gram of water. So first of all, the molecular weight or atomic mass of molecular mass of water, it's 18. So 18 gram of water is equal to 6.022 × 10²³ molecules. So that 3.6 gram of water, which already given, is equal to 6.022 × 10²³ into 3.6 by 18. So the result will be 1.206 × 10²² molecules. Now the next formula, number of particles, number of moles of particles into Avogadro's number. So the question, calculate the number of atoms in 0.5 moles of carbon. The number of atoms 0.5 × 6.022 × 10²³ is equal to 3.0115 atoms. Now, the numericals based on mole concept. Calculate the number of moles in 12 gram of oxygen gas? This is the first question on numerical. First of all, 32 gram of oxygen gas is equal to 1 mole. Student, 32 gram of oxygen gas is equal to 1 mole. So why it's 32 gram? Oxygen gas means O2, not only O. So 1 oxygen is equal to 16. Its atomic mass is 16. So oxygen gas means O2. So 16 into 2, so is equal to 32. So that's why 32 gram of oxygen gas is equal to 1 mole. 12 gram of oxygen gas is what? So 12 into 1 by 32, so is equal to 0.375 mole. Second question, calculate the number of moles present in 12 gram of carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide, its formula is CO. So 28 gram of carbon monoxide is equal to 1 mole. 14 gram of carbon monoxide is equal to how much? Is equal 14 into 1 by 28. So is equal to half. So is equal to 0.5 mole. Find the mass. Question number 3. Find the mass of 5 moles of aluminium atoms. Atomic mass of aluminium atom, it's 27 gram. 5 moles of aluminium atom is 5 into 27 gram is equal to 135 gram. Question number 4. Calculate the molar mass of sulfur. Sulfur is a polyatomic molecule. It is made up of 8 sulfur atoms. So that's why atomic mass of sulfur atoms is 32 gram. Molar mass of sulfur, 8 into 32 is equal to 256 gram. Question number 5. Calculate the mass of 0.2 mole of water molecules. 1 mole of water molecules is 18 gram. 0.2 mole of water molecules is 0.2 into 18. So that is 3.6 gram. Question number 6. Which has greater number of atoms? 100 gram of sodium or 100 gram of iron? Atomic mass of sodium, it's 23 U, and iron 56 U. Iron, its symbol is Fe. So answer, 1 mole of substance contains the number of particles is equal to Avogadro's constant. So 1 mole of sodium is equal to 23 gram. 23 gram of sodium contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. 100 gram of sodium contains 100 into 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 by 23. Okay. So the result will be 4.3 into 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. This is the first, means 100 gram of sodium contents. Now the next is 1 mole of iron is equal to 56 gram. Because its atomic mass is, iron atomic mass is 56 gram of iron contains 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. 100 gram of iron contains 100 into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 by 56. So the result will be 1.78 into 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. So therefore, which one is greater? 100 gram of sodium has greater number of atoms than 100 gram of iron. Question number 7. How many atoms of oxygen are present in 300 gram of calcium carbonate? Calcium carbonate, its chemical formula is CaCO3. Molecular mass of calcium carbonate, 40 plus 12 into 3 into 16 is equal to 100 gram. 40 plus 12 into 4 plus 48 is equal to 100 gram. So calcium carbonate, its molecular mass 100 gram. Okay. 1 mole of calcium carbonate contains 3 mole of oxygen atoms. 100 ग्राम ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट कंटेंट 3 इनटू एवोगाड्रोस नंबर मीन 6.023 × 10⁻²³ एटम्स. 300 ग्राम ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट कंटेंट 300 इनटू 3 इनटू 6.023 × 10⁻²³ बाय 100. सो द रिजल्ट विल बी 54.207 × 10⁻²³ ऑक्सीजन एटम्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. Calculate the number moles of magnesium in 0.478 gram of magnesium. Atomic mass of magnesium is 24 gram. So 24 gram of magnesium is equal to 1 mole. 0.478 gram of magnesium is equal to 0.478 into 1 by 24 is equal to 0.019 mole. The answer will be 0.019. Now the question number 10. Find the number of oxygen atoms in 88 gram of carbon dioxide. Molar mass of carbon dioxide is 44 gram or mole. Number of moles of carbon dioxide present in 88 gram of CO2 is equal to 88 gram or 44 gram per mole. Is equal to 2 moles. 1 mole of carbon dioxide contains 2 mole of oxygen atoms. 2 moles of carbon dioxide contains 4 moles of oxygen atoms. 1 mole of oxygen contains 6.023 × 10⁻²³ atoms of oxygen. 4 moles of oxygen contains 4 × 6.023 × 10⁻²³. So 24.092 × 10⁻³. So 2.4092 × 10⁻²⁴ atoms of oxygen. So therefore 88 gram of carbon dioxide contains 2.4092 × 10⁻²⁴ atoms of oxygen. Now the next question, find the number of aluminium ions present in 0.051 gram of aluminium oxide, Al2O3. Atomic masses of aluminium is 27U and oxygen is 16U. Now the answer will be molecular weight of aluminium oxide is 102 gram. 102 gram of aluminium oxide contains 6.022 × 10⁻³ molecules. Therefore, 0.051 gram of aluminium oxide content into number of molecules. X is equal to X number of molecules. So, X here 0.051 into 6.022 × 10⁻³ by 102. So, the result will be 0.003 × 10⁻². So, X will be 3 × 10⁻². 1 mole of aluminium oxide contains 2 aluminium ions. 3 × 10⁻²⁰ molecules contains 2 × 3 × 10⁻²⁰. So the result will be 6 × 10⁻²⁰ aluminium ions. Therefore, 0.051 gram of aluminium oxide contains 6 × 10⁻²⁰ aluminium ions. Now there is few extra questions, numerical problems based on mole concept. So, the first question, calculate the mass of 6.022 × 10⁻³ molecule of calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Molar mass or molecular mass in gram of calcium carbonate is equal to 100 gram. Number of moles of calcium carbonate 6.022 × 10⁻³ by 6.022 × 10⁻³, that answer will be 1 mole. The mass of calcium carbonate is equal to number of moles into molar mass is equal to 1 × 100 gram is equal to 100 gram. Calculate the mass of 12.044 × 10⁻³ gram carbon atoms. Solution, number of moles of carbon atoms, number of atoms by Avogadro's constant is equal to 12.044 × 10⁻³ by 6.022 × 10⁻³ is equal to 2 moles. The mass of carbon atoms is equal to number of moles into atomic mass. 2 × 12 is equal to 24 gram. Calculate the number of oxygen atoms in 1 mole of oxygen. Solution, 1 molecule of oxygen is equal to 2 oxygen atoms. So, 1 mole of oxygen is equal to 2 mole oxygen atoms. 2 into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. The result will be 12.044 into 10 to the power 23 oxygen atoms. Question number 4. Calculate the number of copper atoms in 0.635 gram of copper. Solution, number of moles of copper, mass of copper by atomic mass is equal to 0.635 by 63.5. So it's 0.01 mole. So number of copper atoms, number of moles into Avogadro constant. So 0.01 into Avogadro's constant. So result will be 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 copper atoms. Question number 5. Calculate the number of oxygen atoms and its mass is 50 gram of calcium carbonate. Solution, molar mass of calcium carbonate 100. Number of moles of calcium carbonate 50 gram by 100 gram. So that is 0.5. So 0.5 mole of calcium carbonate contains 1.5 mole of oxygen atoms. Number of oxygen atoms 1.5 into Avogadro's number. So it is equal to 9.033 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. Mass of oxygen atoms is equal to 1.5 into 16 is equal to 24 gram. Question number 6. Calculate the number of atoms of each element in 122.5 gram of KClO3. Solution, molecular mass of KClO3 is equal to 39 plus 35.5 plus 3 into 16. Molecular mass of KClO3 is equal to 122.5. Number of mole KClO3 is equal to 122.5 gram by 122.5 gram. So is equal to 1 mole. 1 mole of KClO3 contains 1 mole of potassium, 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 K atoms. 1 mole of chlorine also contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 chlorine atoms. 3 mole of oxygen contains 3 into Avogadro's constant, that is also 1.806 into 10 to the power 24 oxygen atoms. Watch the video carefully and repeatedly to understand properly. Stay tuned for all video updates. Please comment in the comment box for all your doubts in this chapter. I will make video for all questions raised by students. Please don't skip the video. Otherwise, you will miss the important part. All the numericals are solved very carefully and clearly. Still, if any single student is unable to understand any part of the video, please let me know in the comment box. Thank you all students for watching the video carefully and repeatedly to understand properly. Stay tuned for all video updates. Please comment for your doubtful questions in the comment box. I will make video for all questions raised by students. Please don't skip the video, else you will miss the important part. Please like, share and subscribe the video of the channel Agito Education. Don't forget to click the bell icon so that I can send you an intimation for my every latest video.